You ready?
Yeah. You know, I fully body bad God attack, you know. You represent for the sound off. I mean, I say, yo, Karen, yo, Triple X. When that one that drop, then Triple Vex. Fully.
Run it.
When you want you the sound off, the sound off, you can't listen it and don't laugh. The sound off. Hear me, I say, keep it represent for the fullest, and I mean, for the sound off. Monday to Friday, 1 to 3. On Nationwide 90 FM, the new revolution in media. Mad.
That I'm ready. Show them what beans do.
Okay. At the sound of Nationwide, 90 FM, 1 to 3 p.m. Live.
They believe in us. God did.
What's up? It's Megan Sue, and you're listening to the Sound Off on Nationwide 90 FM.
Nah, malalai.
Sound Off, Monday to Friday, on Nationwide 90 FM.
This is Beanie Man. Give it to them. Saga, Zen.
Oh, you're me.
All right.
You hear me, Cinnamon, and Dexter, that's it. You're listening to the Sound Off. 1 to 3 every day.
The number one power mixer, DJ Jerome, the show boss.
Zone up, Monday to Friday. Zone up, Monday to Friday. Zone up, Monday to Friday. And Nationwide, 90 FM. And Nationwide, 90 FM. And Nationwide, 90 FM. Zone up, Monday to Friday. 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 And Nationwide, 90 FM.
This is Beanie Man. Give it to them, Zaga. Zen.
Hello, testing. Talk back. Hello, everybody. Guess what? It is Thursday. It is Relationship Thursday. It is April 11th. Do you know that in 4 days, we will now be in the middle of April? And you know, after that, you know what happens, right? It's the end of April. And then, so producer just says April is the best month. It can be the second best month as long as you do know that February is the best month and you know why. I mean, not only you have Bob Marley, you have Dennis Brown, you have Reggae Month, you have Black History Month.
A lot of people
and
will disagree.
You mean, of course, we have to talk about it again. And of course, it's my month. So I don't know how Miss Lady inside here, Rochelle Pinnock, going to come tell me, say, April is the best month. And just interrupt my whole welcome and hello and all of these things to come and just give me this scandalous information. But anyway, I digress and I will continue on. Now, as I said to you guys, welcome to the entertainment block with me, Karen Design Diva Booker, Triple X, and of course, the wonderful Shell Boss over there.
The wonderful.
The one and only DJ Jerome. Now, Triple, I had to take a little, you know, side move today, so I'll be on my lonesome. Please be kind. Yes. YouTube, how you doing? You all right? You okay? You good? And I have exactly, because you know what's going to happen here, right? Razzie is going to co-host with me. DJ Jerome is going to co-host with me. And then I have all of YouTube. And I also have all of the people who are riding around at 1 o'clock between 1 and 3. There, you guys are just going to call in. By the way, I don't know any other audience out there who, when we want to give you stuff, you don't come for it. And when we want to give you stuff, you don't partake. Listen now, we have some things here. People, if you have one paint, please, may I beg you, come for it, please, because we have many people in this studio who really, really and truly want it. The next thing, we have Design Studio today. We will be giving away paint. Please call in from 2 o'clock. Just keep calling and keep calling. You understand? So, as you know, we have a huge show for you today. We have Rip from the Headlines, you know, where we get to just take all these things. We have Talk Your Mind. We have What's on Your Lunch Menu. What's on Your Lunch Menu today is all about romantic food. 876-280-6629. Also, you guys did not, and you see, you didn't grade yesterday, and you don't even let us know. You don't remind us, because if you don't remind us, we're not gonna remember. We have too much things. Yes. Oh, that's right. Okay, so remember now, because we had a live stream yesterday, you guys didn't get to send in food. So please, send in your food today, and then YouTube will help me to grade. All right, so after that, now we have the Design Studio. Design Studio is all about the design quiz. Yes, you get to win paint, and if you don't win paint just by participating, you know what you win, right? You win credit. So you walk away with something. So we're asking you, please, I'm begging you, call in 630-9371-4. Also, if you have not yet gone over to the Google App Store and downloaded the Nationwide 90 FM Live, then I suggest that you do so now. After you do that, you will definitely engage with us, share, and like up the thing when we're on. All right, let's get to it. Let's do some work.
An extra, extra! Read all about it!
It's ripped from the headlines!
So as you guys know, we have some very sad news today. O.J. Simpson has passed away. You remember years and years ago, you remember that Bronco going down the highway? I remember that. This man polarized the world. He split the U.S. of A. and the world in terms of guilty or not guilty. The Johnny Cochran, the antics of him, Robert Kardashian. I mean, it was something else. So, a legend is gone and his legacy lives on. All right, so O.J. Simpson has really passed away as his family made the news public via his X account, formerly Twitter, on Thursday, which is today. According to the brief statement, O.J.'s death was due to a battle with cancer. He died on April 10th at the age of 76. On April 10, our father, Orenthal James Simpson, succumbed to his battle with cancer. He was surrounded by his children and grandchildren. During this time of transition, his family asked that you please respect their wishes for privacy and grace, the statement read. Now, Mr. Simpson, yes, you know him, Jerome.
Yeah, I've heard the name.
You've heard the name, so you don't know about O.J. Simpson. Yeah, O.J. Simpson he played football, not soccer, no, football. And he won, you know, the trophies and what you call that, the something other trophy, Heisman. Right. And he was really gifted at what he did. And so he will go down in history as that case in court where his wife was killed. He was tried for it. He was let go. He was acquitted. But he would later went and robbed somebody else's house dressed in all black to get back his stuff. He had his things. So he went over there. He robbed and then he served 8 to 10 years. Yeah, so he has had a really colored history. Mm. Now, here's the thing now where, you know, it gets juicy, it gets really juicy. You know Caitlyn Jenner?
Yeah.
The trans lady, the trans man who became woman and now she's like Caitlyn. She was married to his wife who is, what's her name again? Kris Jenner, exactly. Married to Kris. And Kris is the mother of the Kardashian sisters plus Kylie and the other one, the model, right? Okay. Now, it has been rumored that the middle daughter, right? Not Kim. You have Kim and then you have Khloe and then the last one is Courtney. Well, Courtney was first and then Kim. Right. So, Courtney is his daughter. You don't can't say I say it. I just heard it. Don't kill the messenger. But when you really look at the features and you look at the height and you look at all of these things, she don't really look like Kim and she don't look like Courtney. Mm-hmm. She kind of look like the mother. Yeah, but it's rumored. So Caitlyn now came on his post and said good riddance on Twitter, which is X. Caitlyn came and said, yeah, she said, good riddance, hashtag OJ Simpson. So let me just tell you something. Something could be in something. There's something. Can you imagine? No reverence. The man just passed and whatever. And then, no, you're just going here. Good riddance from Miss Caitlyn. So that got 9.1 million views, 1.4 thousand reposts, and 8.4 thousand quotes, 12,000 likes, and 819 bookmarks. Okay. So apparently, you know, what I just said about the paternity of Miss Chloe, you know, he has now concretized by all of this scandal. You know what I mean? Because this is scandalous. This is certainly scandalous. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. The man has just died and you're just going to come out and say good riddance. Why would you say good riddance, miss? Why? Unless it's something that, you know, you really needed to air out. Mm-hmm. But, you know, yeah, it's quite something. So here's the thing now. Moving on in the news. Another Valiant Fresh drop. What? Is coming soon after the dancehall star announced the April 12 release date for his upcoming project titled Flavor. Valiant, you are so on fire right now. The Diplomat's top man shared the update with fans via his Instagram stories on Thursday. The preview comes 2 weeks after he teased his other track, Blueprint, via his IG stories, which also tagged record label Sony Music UK in the post as anticipation continues ahead of his first EP since signing with the label. Gonna take a little break and then we're just gonna come right back and get into Valiant.
Importers, shipments requiring you to pay customs duties and taxes are cleared on a customs goods declaration known as an IM4 or IMS4. Ask your clearing agent to provide your customs declaration, customs assessment notice, and customs receipt once duties and taxes are paid. Where your clearing agent may not be able to provide the IM4 or IMS4, request your customs goods declaration registration number or C number, which can be used to verify your payments. Importers, request your IM4, IMS4, or C number. It is your right. For details, email the Jamaica Customs Agency at public.relations@jca.gov.jm. Jamaica Customs, keeping our customers in focus.
Who shops at Creative Building Finishes? You, the homeowner who creates luxurious spaces with our floor and wall tiles. The contractor and builder who are convinced that our ceramic tiles are right for the job. The architect and designer who make dreams come true with our wood look and porcelain tiles. Superior customer service, knowledgeable staff, inviting showroom, and you get where this is going, right? Shop 5 Red Hills Road or call 876-929-5553. Get tiles, get Creative Building Finishes.
Nationwide 90 FM, the station for the very latest in news and current affairs, will broadcast information about Zed Jamaica's 21 years in business. On Thursday, April 11 from 6 to 8 p.m., tune in to Nationwide at 5 to hear about Zed's groundbreaking projects, which includes creating innovative videos, captivating animations, engagements with the Fax Assist Ren Web School Management System, creating innovative e-learning videos, and more. That's a live broadcast of Zed Jamaica's 21 years in business during Nationwide at 5, Thursday, April 11 from 6 to 8 p.m. only on Nationwide 90 FM, the new revolution in media. This broadcast is brought to you by Zed Jamaica.
Sound off, Monday to Friday on Nationwide 90 FM. This is Lee, man. Give it to them.
Look on, we are fighter. Call me a fighter.
Another great big up to everybody on the chat. I see you, and I know you see me. So what's going on? I see KT Buello. I see Chance. I see Clash Camp. I see SH. I see Sandra Parker. I see Shanique. I see KT. Okay, I saw KT already. Marigold, where are you? Okay, here we go. Roslyn. And you see, it takes me a while to go through all these names. You know, Andrea Henry. So here it is, thing now. Right, you're here every day. Like up the thing, nobody, just like it up, please. May I beg you, please. All right, so let's get right back into it. So Valiant is doing his thing, He is flying that flag. He is signed now to Sony Music UK, and he is making his collaborations and he's making his connections and he's doing everything. And then, you know, he is now going to release his EP tomorrow titled Flavor. So everybody, please, may I beg you, look out for it, because Valiant, yes, you made your mark in history. I think it was 2 years ago where you first came onto the scene, and we just know that, hey, listen, you are somebody who, you're bright, you're shining your star, you're taking up space, you're not going to dim your light for anything. You are one of Jamaica's best. So I wish you all the best, and I really hope that this EP right here is all that is cracked up to be. What do you have to say about that, Shell Boss?
Yeah, Valiant is a phenomenal artist.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man, from him. Forward upon the scene. Mm-hmm. Been doing good work. He put in the work and thing. Mm-hmm. You know, we'll look a mishap with him same way, but him but keep focused.
But who don't have mishaps? I mean, mishap exactly. Is part of being
on the journey,
especially yeah. As you are a young dancehall artist and you come, you have a whole heap of things these people have to face, you know, and because of us in our humanness, sometimes we tend to be a little judgy. Mm. But just remember now, if you don't live in a glass house, show a stone. Right. Okay, so here's the thing now. International dancehall artist Byron Messier has called on artists in the spotlight to give a strength to more up-and-coming talent following his recent performance in New York, where he shared the stage with an aspiring dancehall act, Skyco. The big cake is enough for all of us. Each one help one. It feels good to give another artist an opportunity, the Taliban's DJ told the star. Remember, we were all young artists at some point. Don't forget that when the fame comes, stay real to the game.
Fox.
Yeah. Messia and Skyco said the initial link was created through working with their public relations officer, Carl Durant, which allowed them to have a family-like bond. The Caribbean-American artist Messia has been making a musical impact since his rise to fame in 2023, collaborating with a number of international acts such as Burna Boy and Chris Brown. Skyco expressed gratitude for Messia's gesture, suggesting that these actions need to be displayed more in music. It means a lot because these opportunities are rare and the majority of the dancehall community lacks support, especially for new artists like myself, Skyco told the star. Like I told Byron at the end of my performance, respect me, G, because enough artists wouldn't give me a strength, you know, especially being a new artist, whether my song was hot or not, he added. Yeah, let me tell you. Take it away, please. But it's true. I don't know what it is. It's like, listen, why can't we? I don't care whether it's dancehall, it's reggae, whatever it is, whatever industry you are. You need to give strength to the people who are coming up. It's not going to take anything from you.
I think it's a rivalry in terms of a man securing his spot, you know, being fear of another artist, boss bigger in some cases. But we need unity still, you know what I mean?
But here's... In the universal
look
law,
real.
Yeah, in the universal law of things, let me tell you something. The more you give, is the more you get back. You Simple. Understand? So if it is, and let me tell you something, we do not have unlimited life, right?
No.
So some of us are, it's whatever industry, some of us are in it for ourselves, some of us are in the game to forward the industry and make the industry something that is really world class and world stage. The only way you can do that is if you send that elevator back down and hold them hand on each floor. You understand what I'm saying? So where it is when Byron said, listen man, we need more collaborations, we need to give the young artists some spotlights and give them strength, that's exactly what we need to do. You know what I mean? Because let me tell you something. Yeah. It is passing the baton. Mm-hmm. After you get to a certain stage, what else are you going to do? Unpopular opinion. Unpopular opinion.
Yeah.
These people who are hot in the 90s, the 2000s, the 80s, and so on. Are they hot now? No. You have to send down, you have to pass that baton to people now who are hot and who are oncoming. So you have now become the godfather or the godmother. Mm-hmm. You understand what I'm saying? When people come out of jail and you say, everybody now come and they say, oh my God, we're going to go to that long walk, the concert, and whatever the case is. Has any songs been made that have a really grab? No. So you have to go give people strength. And that's just one artist I'm talking about. For the many artists that are out there, if you have any kind of linkages at all and so on, help the younger ones. And you will only come out smelling like a rose. I am telling you. And for Baron Messier to come and say something like that. And when he says the cake is big enough for all of us, you know, it certainly is. Because you can blow up on one stage, but guess what? No, you might not blow up on another. But you can help somebody and you will always be blessed for it.
Yeah,
you understand what I'm saying?
Good and good and follow.
It's just that. So when you say that, you know, it feels and it feels good to give another artist an opportunity.
Yeah.
You know, and you know me. It's all about, you know, raising that flag on the world stage. It's all about the collaborations.
Yeah.
You know, as I, you know, say every single day as I come on this air, I'm like, listen, you can't do anything by yourself. You need a team of people. You need good management. And you need to form international collaborations. It is the international collaborations and those linkages that are going to help you to propel your music forward. You understand what I'm saying? So yeah, it really feels good. It looks good. You know, Yanni says, remember when we're all young artists at some point, don't forget where the fame comes from.
True.
You know what I'm saying? Stay real to the game because everybody did hungry one time.
Yeah.
You know, and not because you might find or get a little bit of, you know, you feed that little hunger and whatnot. If you do not have the right management, if you do not have the right structure, all of it just going cave down like a sandcastle.
Crumble down.
It's going to crumble. It is going to crumble. You know what I mean? So yeah, respect. Good. I like that talk. I like it because I really feel that we have so much talent in Jamaica. When it comes to sports, when it comes to music, we have whole heap of talent. What we need to do now, because we do perform so well on the world stage, is to be able to capitalize on it and to bottle it. If we can bottle that Jamaican energy, oh my God, every last one of us would be millionaires. So here's the thing now. We are just gonna take a little break and come right back.
As a parent, you give your children a good start in life. You nurture, protect, and guide them. Parenting is a process that prepares your child for independence. As your child grows and develops, there are many things you can do to help your child. Stay tuned to The Big Show, Nationwide This Morning, for parenting tips. Fridays at 6:53 a.m. Only here will you learn everything you need to know about parenting. Tips to help parents navigate the incredibly challenging and rewarding journey of a child rearing. Parenting tips on Nationwide at 90 FM, the revolution in media.
Watch for Shelly and Price.
I stay locked to the Olympics because, of course, I'm Jamaican. What do you mean? Me, I have to tune into the Olympics, man. Because I'm always busy, but what? Afternoon when Sherika Jackson beat Shakari.
Brother, Mafia have every notification for the Olympics. I want to hear every run.
Now Sherika Jackson coming
every
up.
Every jump.
Oh, that is absolutely huge of way pinker.
And every fling, live.
So, take us then.
Nothing can miss me.
We're always on the move.
So while we're driving, run, Elaine, run.
Jogging.
Yes.
Run, Watson, win again.
Watson is now a world champion.
Or even at work.
Quick, the race has started.
We can't miss a beat because we keep it locked.
To the only station.
For the Paris Olympics.
Nationwide.
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 Nationwide. 90 FM.
Nationwide, 90.1, 90.3, 90.5, 90.7, and 90.9. And on YouTube at Nationwide 90 FM Live. Nationwide, the new revolution in media.
On my mind this morning.
On my mind this morning.
On my mind this morning.
This year, Nationwide This Morning will be sharing the microphone and space with opinion leaders, newsmakers, and society's movers and shakers. Join us weekday mornings at 6:30 for What's On My Mind, where we'll feature several commentators focusing on issues affecting Jamaicans and our beloved country. We'll amplify what matters to you: politics, the economy, crime and security, gender, culture, entertainment, and everything in between. Tune in to Ricardo, Tana, and Saeed and our new commentators every weekday morning at 6:30 for What's On My Mind. Only on Nationwide 90 FM, the new revolution in media.
But is this real? Hey, Greg, come look at this. Oh my, it's happening. Mr. Daniels, the numbers keep getting bigger and bigger.
Sir, the clicks are off the charts.
Hello, sales. What's the emergency? 9,000 clicks in one day? 3,000 order? So much we have left. What? I'll soon call you back. Mr. Nakamoto, it's Danny from Jamaica. I need 5,000 of the big ones. We're back in business.
Yes, sir. Arigato. Sweat it.
Amplify your brand. Let Nationwide 90 FM assist you in tapping into a captivated audience across our social media platforms. For more information, contact us at 876-630-1210 or sales@nationwidenewsnetwork.com. Businesses, companies, and entrepreneurs, let's supercharge your brand.
So now, Monday to Friday, on Nationwide, 90 FM.
This yo, Frax, may I check my mind by now? May I check my mind by now? I'm in the business, may I do things? Rock up,
we no care who fix, 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 we no care who fix.
So, you know, last weekend was the culmination of the carnival season. You know that throughout the month of March, beginning February, holy papatis, carnival has become, I'm not going to say bigger, but a huge, huge, huge income machine for Jamaica, you know. And if we don't watch it, it's going to start to rival dance hall. It just will. You know, in terms of dollars and cents. Because, you know, you have to break these things down in science and fact. Not necessarily opinion. Mm. So, the thing is, no, you know, when these folks come, and they come from far and wide, you know, near and far, and all countries and so on, they come to just capture the spirit of carnival in Jamaica, which is second to none. It's a different carnival in Barbados. It's a different carnival in Trinidad. It's just different. Jamaica, we have our own kind of spice, right? So, as you know, Mr. Jerome, enough money them pay for them costumes.
Yeah.
We're talking about, you know, $1,000 up to $3,000. Enough. Yes, and of course, Mr. Razzy is there over the weekend because that's his thing. Oh, yeah. How much you pay? How much you pay for your costume, DJ Razzy? Okay. No, you weren't in costume? Can I see pictures, please? I know you say you cover it. I know you said, but I'd love to see what you had on. Thank you very much. Because we want to see where Razzy was. David was there too. David, can I see what you wore, please? But meanwhile, I was at church. You understand? And I did say that I was going to pray for everybody at church. And I'm going to pray for you on Monday as well. Because all of you carnivalites, I expect to see you in church come next Sunday. It's okay, Christ in culture. You know what I mean? So, as you know, enough money for the costume name. You understand? And not only the costumes, it is the glam up. You know, they have glam hubs all over the place where you have to go in. You glam up, you meaning your makeup and so on. And you know these costumes, it's like a million and one different strings. So, you can't dress yourself. So, you have these dresses. And after that, you have the photography and the whole thing. So it's a whole experience, right? Yeah. All right, fine. So I want you guys now to listen to this little clip about the experience that this one carnival reveler had. Ready, Raz?
I'm not surprised at all by these comments. Like, I knew you guys were going to come on my video and try to make it seem like I'm being stush and I don't like people and carnival is only for the rich and the elite. No. Carnival is for everybody. However, if you paid $1,000 US to be there, you deserve to be in a different section than the people who did not pay. It's not right for people who paid so much money to be mixing in the same area and cannot get to breathe because there's people who did not pay in that area. It's not right. You guys did not pay. Normally, there is a rope, and everybody who wants to see Carnival who did not pay can see it from the outside. You can join the Carnival from the outside. You can be at the back, the sides, and everybody enjoy. But only people who pay should be within the ropes, within the means that the band has made, the band that you paid your money to.
Okay, all right. Okay, calm down, girl. Calm down. You're gonna have a coronary. Calm down. The things that make people go ballistic. All right, here's the situation now. I'm looking at it from all aspects. I'm gonna approach the bands first, and I'm saying, listen, you know these people pay you a whole heap of money, right? And they pay you the money for the experience of Carnival. The experience. So therefore, there is a responsibility of when you apportion that money to make sure that these people get the experience that they pay for and that they deserve. Cool? So the money is not just for the costumes. Mm-hmm. The money is for, you know, when they're on the road, that they have, and you know how Jamaicans are. We love to be VIPs. We love to be elite. We want to be in our little corner because that's what we pay for. Honestly, I have a thing with seats as well. When I'm traveling, I want a good seat. If I'm at the theater, I want a good seat. If I go to the cinema, that's my seat. But that's my thing. You understand? And I'm not cocky with it or whatever the case is. That's just my lifestyle. All right, cool. So my lady pay her money, and then she realized that, hey, listen, everybody come. No, yes, I do understand that everybody, you know, who has seen her comment is going to jump on her and say she looks classist, she's this, she's that, and whatever. But if you pay a certain amount of money for an experience, that is what, regardless of what she's saying. Regardless of what, oh, she didn't feel safe, and blah, blah. Yeah, we get that. But regardless, Ms. Arazi, of what the experience is, right? That's what I'm expecting. If you pay your money. Mm-hmm. Right? Continue.
Yeah, so I was out on the road.
I know you were. I know.
Yeah, with the Nationwide team. And for me still, I didn't really see anything out of place.
Mm-hmm.
But I guess towards the back of the line, mm-hmm. Towards the back of the marches, you know, mm-hmm. There were a lot of people who
yes.
came in, and you didn't really see some of the ropes
yes.
for some of the bands as well. But I yes. think that's like far back. So I don't know if it was, you know, in that early part of the morning where she had experienced that, where she had expects, you know, near to the front and the middle of the line,
mm-hmm.
you know, you'd have people who in the ropes. So I don't know what really happened with her per mm-hmm. se, but from my experience mm-hmm. being out there,
mm-hmm.
everything did look orderly. At one point, I did see, like, closer to the afternoon session after them take them lunch break and
right.
go back on the road, I noticed that there were more people in
yes.
in the crowd, but yes. I wasn't really checking for like who have on bands, you know.
Okay. Just,
yeah.
With my Carnival experience, mm-hmm. right? I don't go Carnival no more, but I used to go. All right, fine.
Which year was this?
Yeah, don't worry. Got me still young and out. All right. Mm. With my experience, I do notice that after lunch
mm-hmm.
is when all of the lapses occur.
Yeah.
Right? I know that when you're on a truck, right? Because mm-hmm. you know the girl got to be in a truck. When you're on a truck, after lunch is when it's like, hold on, any and everybody start to cut. So we know now that after mm-hmm. lunch, you cut off at a period and you get off of the truck and you go somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? But you do know that if you're a carnivalite, after lunch
mm-hmm.
is when all chaos and madness going to happen because people now have they have drunken themselves into a stupor.
Yeah, from in the morning. Yeah,
from in the morning. Mm-hmm. So you know that the sun hot and so on. This is where you're going to see people are regurgitating on the street and everywhere else, top and bottom. It is mayhem after lunch, you know. However, I did see though, Razi, and I'm thinking the bands are going through growing pains. right now. Yes, definitely. It's tremendous because they did not expect the whole. I mean, it is like a whole. It is a groundswell.
Yeah, because this year I think it was reported that Carnival made an estimate $5 billion.
There you go.
You know, for the influx, because there's been a huge
crowd. Groundswell. Exactly.
You know?
Right?
Yes. All right.
So it's not a matter of rich man, poor man, no, in terms of Carnival. Everybody enjoys Carnival, but it's what you pay for, and you pay for that experience.
Yeah.
What I'm simply saying to, you know, is also, when you look at the spend, because this is what the morning after, Razzie, when I was dropping Aaron to school, Kingston never looked right.
Yeah, I think that there should have been some, you know, allocation. But to be fair, you know, I did see, you know, some of the bands did actually have some people actually cleaning up, like right after the bands passed.
Yes.
You have some people cleaning up, but I don't think that was enough, because
it was
like a little
enough.
Bit of people.
Exactly.
Missing.
I know, you know, when
compared
you go to these
garbage.
Exactly. Jerome, you know, it's like sometimes when you go to these parties and stuff, and usually for every five people there, you see one. You see more cleaners than you see people, because it is all about the experience. And the more high end the experience is, the more you really want to make people feel safe, protective, clean, and all of that. You know what I'm saying? So I know, I'm really thinking that, hey, listen, bands, what I need you guys to do a post-mortem now on how Carnival in Jamaica, where you want to take it, because it's here. It's not going to wear next week, when bigger as well.
Yeah.
Right? I am thinking about this lady, even though she said it however she wants to say it, right? She did say, hey, listen, you know, there's a lapse of security with the ropes and everything, everybody coming in. Because, you know, Jamaicans, you know how we are.
Yeah.
We don't want to pay for nothing, but we want everything. And we want to jump the... Are you when I was younger, you think somebody never jumped fence too?
I did kind of, you know, in the afternoon session when I saw more people, as I'm going to say, I wasn't sure who was exactly with the bands from
who.
Otherwise, from who, they in a costume already. You know, kind of check for unban and them thing there.
No,
you understand?
Because it's after the launch. So I'm thinking, like, with bands, make sure after launch, that is a time where, you know, don't
security,
just be lapsed now with
supposed
the security. Don't be lapsed with the garbage cleanup. Don't be lapsed with people and stuff, because that is the time. Since we all know it, no? That is the time. Because I'm seeing, and let me tell you, you have people now, you know, who, you know, the costumes are very heavy when you're tripsing down the road.
Yeah.
Right? Then we'd pick up the costume, put it on, and act like them belong.
To me, still, I like the vibe. You know, in the afternoon session, as I must say, the crowd got bigger. You know, everybody look like them that have fun.
Yes.
A lot of people look, you know, intoxicated.
Yes.
You know, and as I say, it's growing pains, you know?
It's growing pains,
yes. So I think we have a kind of beer with them, and I guess they will be learning from this experience.
I really hope so.
You know, and try to make it better next year. But I don't know if it grows again.
But we really hope, you know, I really, you know, Jamaica is great. Jamaica is good, but we really need to learn from our experiences. $5 billion to come into Carnival alone is not pocket change. We have all of these influencers coming in to enjoy Carnival in Jamaica. Let's not blow it. Let's not have people talk. Of course, it's TikTok. It's social media. People go and talk when they talk and whatever the case is. But at the end of the day, I want people to come here to Jamaica to enjoy, to experience, and of course, and spend a whole heap of money when you come. You know what I'm saying? With that, we're going to take a little break and come right back. And remember, what's on your lunch menu coming up? Please, may I beg you, send in the food. YouTube, you're going to help me too, you're going to grade. And then, everybody, if you want to win a gallon of paint, now is the time to start calling in so that you can win a gallon of paint, courtesy of BH Paints. A little quiz, not going to hurt nobody. And as you know, it's with, as like CXC, the questions do come back. Yeah.
Importers, shipments requiring you to pay customs duties and taxes are cleared on a customs goods declaration known as an IM4 or IMS4. Ask your clearing agent to provide your customs declaration, customs assessment notice, and customs receipt once duties and taxes are paid. where your clearing agent may not be able to provide the IM-4 or IMS-4. Request your customs goods declaration registration number or C number, which can be used to verify your payments. Importers, request your IM-4, IMS-4, or C number. It is your right. For details, email the Jamaica Customs Agency at public.relations@jca.gov.jm. Jamaica Customs, keeping our customers in focus.
Get ready for some fun every Saturday as the Jamaica Observer brings you Saturday Games Corner. Put your skills and creativity to the test for a chance to win exciting prizes each week.
Hold up, wait a minute.
Don't miss out on the fun and surprises.
You serious?
Grab your copy of the Jamaica Observer this Saturday and get ready to win.
Back to life. Back to reality.
Jamaica is fully open, business is back, and Nationwide 90 FM will put you on the right track. We've missed doing outside broadcasts with you, our valued clients. Let's partner again to bring your customers closer face to face. If your business needs a kickstart, pull or push, whether urban, rural, or deep in the bush, give our sales team the dates and we'll give you the best rates. Nationwide 90 FM will take your goods and services to the world through our radio, YouTube, and Instagram channels. Let's bring back the buzz in your business. It's time to touch the road with our outside broadcast, giving vibes and value to you anywhere, anytime, day or night.
What's best for my business?
Nationwide 90 FM, a revolution in media.
Tune in to Nationwide 90 FM, the new revolution in media. Stay ahead of the curve with our cutting-edge reporting and accurate breaking news coverage.
We are having an earthquake. Oh, God.
Hear it here first on Nationwide 90 FM.
Is that really clip you started?
Tune in, turn up the volume, and listen. We bring a mix of news, entertainment, and sports to your lives.
Nationwide 90 FM's live and continuous coverage of the World Championships in Budapest, Hungary.
News and discussions week mornings.
Coming up in the news at 6 for this morning.
Entertainment in the afternoons, then news again in the evenings.
Nationwide news at this hour, fired.
Also, tune in to the entertainment and sports shows in the nights and on the weekends.
It is Boya Ting's After Dark Retro on Nationwide 90 FM.
Everything is news, from current affairs and entertainment to sports, business, and other categories.
Nationwide 90 FM. This is me, man. Give it to them. Zaga, Zen.
From every whisper to every commotion.
That's rubbish. The KSAMC cannot investigate itself.
What? Click News really talking like that?
Every news story unfolds here first at Nationwide 90 FM, the new revolution in media. Every sound is a story, and every story we share is news.
Sound up, Monday to Friday, on Nationwide 90 FM. This is
Beanie Man. People, me have something to tell you now. A long, long time me wait. But see, the time is right, time is now. Me turn the stove down low and just pull the windows open. I'm in the mood, so me not go spoil it. Bet you I go want me cook again. Saying, ooh, it's been a long, long time. I'm cooking some ackee for you, girl. But it seems like you never like rice. So I'm gonna get some flour first. And I want to give you some good. I want to give you some good to jump in.
It's lunchtime. What's on your lunch menu?
Knife and fork, a fight for dumpling. Any of you guys were around when this song was hot? Jerome, did you know this song? When this song, Knife and Fork, a fight for dumpling.
I wasn't going to parties at that time, but yeah, I know this song. It's a big song.
No, Shaba.
Yeah.
You know Shaba is here, Shaba. Right? And I'm going to, yes, he will be performing in Arnett Gardens, and I wouldn't mind going. Him and Josie Wales and all of these people. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Tony B was talking about it earlier. Like, Shaba is here? Oh, my God. Gotta go to see Shaba. Do you know that when Shaba was coming to, when he was to perform at some fest, that was the year of COVID. And I was so disappointed. I only hope that he will be performing this year at some fest.
Shaba.
My mouth to everybody's ears, we need Shaba at some fest. All right, cool. So we have food. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Ooh, Lord have mercy, Jesus. What is it? You guys, you've never heard me so excited over food. This looks like parrot. And of course, it is very covered. Why? It's steamed fish. Yes. And it's very colorful and nice. Mm. And I can see, Rochelle is what? Okay, so we have broccoli, we have carrots, and carrots are sliced up. And you know, it's not like shredded carrots. We have the crackers, water crackers, broccoli, and okra. And it looks like pumpkin. Is pumpkin or chocho? Cannot look like pumpkin. No, they never say. But you know, and this is parrot, because you know, I know my parrot. This looks really, really, really good. Oh, Karen, guess who it's from? It's from Karen in Kingston. Oh. Karen, I'm sorry I cannot grade you today. The grading is up to everybody YouTube.
Yeah, see the 10s coming in?
Do you see that my screen is very... Okay, the 10s are coming in. The 10s, mm-hmm. Errol is giving it a 10. Angela giving it a 10. Sonny has also given it a 10. Yes, the food looked good. You remember people, if you're in ride along, let me tell you something. Just picture in your mind the perfect plate. Of
could I use some more okra still?
Yeah, well, according to me, according to Mr. Jerome over there, the Shell boss, he says he would want more okra. I am sure Triple would want with like four times as much okra. And then we just want okra, just fill up the plate.
Yes.
Me?
Yes.
No, you can keep the okra. So this here, yes, it's rightfully 10. Everybody's 10, 10, 10, 10, 10 across the board. It's colorful. It has texture. It's well proportioned. Yeah, man, this is rightfully so. It is a good 10. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
this
nice.
Is good. Thanks, you, Karen. Thank you, namesake. Do we have any more coming up? I think steamed fish. What is it? Yeah. Okay. Everybody, 9 and 10, clean and pretty. Issa K said clean and pretty. All right. Okay. Is this tofu with broad beans or butter beans? No description. Let me tell you guys. So who is it from? No? Okay, so we have another pretty plate. My Jean from Mandeville? So My Jean from Mandeville has sent in something that we would never have thought that is from Jean. Welcome back, Jean. Welcome back, Jean. Let me tell you something. Jean got to the drawing board and she you know, honed our craft and she come back. So guess what? I did not know this was from Jean.
No cucumbers.
Jean, cucumbers is your specialty. It's your signature, rather. That's your signature. So I need you to put some cucumbers on the plate so I know when I see it is from you. So now, Jean has on this plate callaloo with baked beans. Oh, in true Jean style, you know, because Jean is very adventurous and creative in her stylings. So, and she really, you know, put things together that don't necessarily need to go together. So she has baked beans and callaloo. All right. So so that's one third. The second third or the two thirds, the other third of the plate now is carrots and string beans, right? And then the other third of the plate looks like broad beans or butter beans and some things that look like tofu chunks. You see, Jerome?
Yeah, I see. To the left.
To the left, right? Looks like tofu. Miss, let's see. You guys on YouTube. What? Okay, SH said too bland. No, man. It's not bland. This is vegetarian cuisine. I would eat this. I think it would be nice and filling. And it's pretty. And of course, it's from Jean in Mandeville. So what you see, my screen is very slow. I don't know what's going on with what you have over there as scores, Jerome.
I see 7.
This is okay.
I see 8.
Okay, you're right. So 9.5. news you show up. You and Marigold come and see you. News said Karen food this. Rick the Cynic says 7. Keith McLean gives it a 10. Okay. But yeah. News Jean, thank you very much for coming back and coming back to class. We appreciate you. So holy pot things coming in now. 9.5, 9. Filene Williams gives it a four. Okay, all right, here we go. So this one now on the screen is from Spanish Town, and it is from Rose is a regular now, you know, everyday Rose. Rose, what is wrong with you? Don't you know that you have to send in the description. Send in the prescription for the description.
Like goat.
This is like it goat?
Curry goat.
Is it goat?
Big chicken.
That's I don't it. Know. That's yeah, it looked like...
Pasta veg.
This one is slow. It looks like curry goat.
The texture of the picture kind of poor.
Yeah, the text, yeah. It looks like curry goat with rice and peas, and the rice and peas looks really good, right? And what else we have there? We have rice and peas. What kind of vegetable? Razzy, zoom up the screen for a minute, please.
I see the toss veg, but...
It's toss veg, but there's something beside the toss veg as well.
Is it mush?
It's... Okay, so people are riding along. It looks like, so you know, we have a healthy serving now of rice and peas. It's well colored and looks really good. And then we have curry goats. So we know that's curry goat. And then we know that's baked chicken as well. We're having issues now with the vegetables. I think the vegetables is broccoli, like chopped broccoli. And then there is something else right beside it. And it looks steamed. So for... everybody on you, they're giving it 10s.
Yeah, what? I see a 9, 10.
9, 10 and all these things.
A lot of 9 and 10.
Yes. What kind of juice is this, you think?
I would think this look like a mango or orange. No, it looks like orange.
Okay.
Can I have a more?
Okay. All right. So Sunday texture. Dinner, this is 9s. Kevin gives it a 10. Baked chicken, cabbage. It could be cabbage, you know. Could be cabbage with things in there. Cabbage, that potato salad. No, Nadine, I do not think that's potato salad. I don't think so at all. And somebody else says, could that be cabbage? Yeah, I believe it's cabbage, but I don't think. It's cabbage, you know. But everything is shredded.
Yes.
Okay, so we have another one on the screen now. And this is from Gracia in Orlando. Yes, you can tell the foreign food. Again, no description. You know, you guys putting yourself on the line when you give us this food without any kind of description. You know, I don't even know what kind of... So, exactly, what is this? What it look like, Rochelle? What it look like, Jerome? Razzy, weigh in. What is this? Is this salmon? Really?
Oh.
I can usually tell when it's salmon, but this... Salmon with sesame seeds and a lick of fancy bush. We don't know what the fancy bush is. Parsley. Right. So there's parsley on top. And we have, and salmon. But nothing to eat with it. No sides? Nothing at all? Okay. All right. So, who sent this in again? Gracia. Gracia from Orlando. Gracia, let me tell you something. You have a very important name, you know, because there's a designer called Gracia. And let me tell you something. I'll swear by your clothes. But, Gracia, we need something else with the salmon. You know what I mean? Like some mashed potatoes or some sweet corn or something. You know what I mean? All right. So, Leroy says it's salmon. Okay. New say watch fancy. SH says, love this salmon plate, but there's nothing with it. You know what I mean? So you're getting, Keith is giving you an 8. Majestic Gabby is giving you an 8. New said, fish on fried rice. Oh, you're right. There is some rice under it. You're absolutely right. There it is. You see, Jerome? Look under. Because now I'm looking at the other screen. There is definitely...
Kind of hide the rest of stuff.
Yes, I guess so. It's served on a bed of wild rice. So it's served on a bed of wild rice. Roslyn said 5 because it's food or what is. No, Roslyn, you're wrong right there. So I don't think that, oh my gosh, almighty. Do you know that everybody, Wendy gives it a 7, Marie Graham gives it a 7, Errol gives it a 6, Lisa K gives it a 7.5. Why, people, why? Okay, our best friends over there at Rocky Point, White Sand Beach. Gonna take a quick time signal and come right back to the food.
J. shibidi bidips. JP said Mary's banana chips. 20% more chips in the banana left no crumbs.
The time by JP said Mary's banana chips is
2 o'clock in the afternoon. So, oh, hold on a second now. Who serve it? Who serve it? Oh, okay. All right, cool. It is curry lobster tail with white rice. Yeah. Okay, there's a passion fruit cocktail, and then there is cucumbers, of course. There is tomatoes, and there is lettuce, and of course, the cup of rice. I really do think that that is a Jamaican thing, Jerome, where you just serve the cup of, you know, the cup, you put the cup, your rice in the cup, and then you just invert it, and that is the thing. Yeah. And then you have cabbage, shredded red cabbage, or, you know, the purple cabbage, and carrots on the side.
Lobster tail look lovely still.
Can I just tell you, the lobster tail looks really good. It looks buttery and nice, nice texture. Oh my God, I haven't had lobster tail in a very long time.
This look nice. This
it
look
really
good.
Does.
This look good, man.
It really does. I love it. Oh my God, Jesus, yes. Okay, what are we giving it? We are, okay, so Ullingale gives it an 8.
I see 10.
I see 10. Katie Buello gives it a 10. Oh, so the drink, what? What?
Okay.
What is that? Passion who? What is that drink?
Passion fruit.
Passion fruit cocktail. So that means there's some measure of liquor in there, some alcohol cocktail. Oh my goodness gracious. This makes it a 10 for me. Mm. The whole meal is an experience.
Bossy.
This is an experience. I'm getting excited. Now I know how Triple feel when he gets excited over the food. I am getting... Let me just describe the excitement. When you get excited over the food, you know, it's a very warm feeling you feel in your stomach. It's like a, and then you reach to your arms and you feel your arms just start to, and this is independent of you. You feel your arms start to, like, you know, when you're doing the duck walk and you're doing the waddle waddle, and then you do your fingers now start to go, like, you start to mash your fingers together. Like, yes, you can just taste the food. Yeah, that is excitement. That is the food excitement. So yes, there is a thing. You do get excited over the food. So let me tell you now. Everybody is giving them. Errol is giving it an 8. Dane Bennett is giving it a 9. Lisa K, a 9. Marie Graham is giving it a 10. Keith McLean, an 8. News, what is wrong with you? News says 7 because it's pretty. Fire Punch Shrimp. It's not shrimp. It's lobster tail. It's lobster tail. Sonny's giving it a 10. And Ullingale gives it a 9. Yeah. If I were grading today, I would have given that a 10 because, yes, it's a full experience. Now, say pretty food here. Mm-hmm. This is from Vanessa, don't it? Who is this from?
This look good.
Okay, all right. So this is stew pork, and this is from Mark the Chef. Mark the Chef. My
big
goodness,
Mark.
Great. Mark, big up you each and every day and every time, because this meal is pretty.
It's full of texture.
I'm sure you probably sent this in just for the man himself, but guess what? He ain't here. So this is what kind of pork? Stew pork? It is stewed pork, right? So people who are in your car, right? I'm going to try my very best to describe this for you. So it is a square plate, and the plate now is placed on the table in the shape of, you know, a diamond, right? Okay, so you have four corners there. So in the upper quadrant, we have vegetables, and then you have the lettuce, cucumber, and tomato, right? On the left side of that, you have the stew pork, right? Now, in the middle, right beside the stew pork, you have the cup of rice. And then you have the rasta pasta, the spiral, on the right side. Now, coming down in the bottom of the plate now, you have okra, you have string beans, and you have carrots. It looked nice. The color alone. Why are you laughing?
Because news if I up on an oink oink.
News. You have to appreciate the food.
News,
you understand what I'm saying?
Rasta,
you have to appreciate the food. So we have rasta.
I'm not going to be biased.
It looks so good.
I don't eat pork either, News.
Yeah, but
I'll
you still have to appreciate
because
the food.
The presentation is on point. It's
exactly.
Very nice.
Not because we don't eat it,
yeah,
right?
I'm not going to be biased.
So you have the rasta pasta on the right, and on the left, you have the oink oink. You have Trenton. Oh, you have Pork. What do you have to call him? Arnold. You know what I mean? So this whole meal right now, really and truly, it have all of the Rasta colors. It has the, and it just looks nice. It's so colorful. So even if you don't eat the oink oink, you will have an appreciation for it. All right, fine. So Lisa K. Williams gives it a 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. Right, Keith McLean, even though I don't eat pork, the presentation is on point, gives it a 10. Angela Greaves gives it a 20 out of 20, perfectly plated, colorful presentation. And Filene Williams, mark the winner today, is 10 plus plus plus. Oh, here, okay, here, okay. Vanessa, no. See, Vanessa coming up with the rare, with stew peas, plain rice, and steamed veg.
No, man,
and
this then, bossy, man.
Look, and okay, people on YouTube, would you please pay your attention to how she has done the cucumber at the top of the plate, and then in the middle of the two cucumbers, you have the rose made out of tomato. You know, I can't make that.
This is crazy.
I can't make that. I can't make it as good as she can, but I can make it, right? And then now, onto the left of the plate, you have stew peas. To the right, you have the cup of rice, and then you have steamed veg. No. All right. YouTubers, what you giving this? And then after you tell me what you giving this, which one do you prefer out of Vanessa's?
To what am I pork, you know?
Yeah, out of Vanessa's and Mark from Mandeville, which one win today? Which one is the winner? Vanessa or Mark? My God, what a plate them pretty. Vanessa or Mark, who going to win? Vanessa and Mark going to buy. Looks good. No, guys, you need to give me a winner because the two of them are them tie. Are them tie. Because I believe, let me tell you something.
Yeah, it's kind of hard though, but... Yo.
Somebody have to be the winner because to me, I must Vanessa. Okay, Clash Camp has voted and he said I must Vanessa. This two, and then other people said I'm Thai. Right, but I think, and you know, this is I'm not putting myself in it. But if I were voting, if I had an opinion would be to Vanessa because she did put an extra thing with the cucumbers,
The creativity, especially with the tomatoes.
Yes. Now, in light of relationship Thursdays, Mr. Jerome is going to, you know, edify us with some musical stylings of, you know, some romantic music because it's Relationship Thursday. So just take it away, please, Mr. Jerome.
So, what do you want to do? I'm here, baby. I'm ready, baby. I'm waiting on you. Believe me, I am patiently waiting. Something wrong with me. Every time I'm alone with you, you keep talking about you loving me. Baby, your foreplay just blows my mind. So why don't we stop all the talking, girl? Why don't we stop wasting time? I've had my share of lovers. Some say I'm
now. since you've been away, boy. I ain't got no plans. No, 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 no. And the sound of the rain against my window pane is slowly, it's slowly driving me insane. Boy, I'm going down.
Remember now, after this is the design studio, we are giving away paint. Why is it so hard to give away? Remember now, the questions do come back. It's just like CXC. We have some people on the line, but we need more because you know how it goes. You know what I'm saying? So 876-630-9371-4. Call in now. Even if you don't win the paint because, you know, you know, got to answer all of them, right? You could win credit. Alrighty. Take it away, DJ Jerome.
No, no mercy. This one is very classic, dedicated to all school as well. Take them.
If you've ever struggled to pass an exam, then you'll know that students today are under great pressure to get good grades and secure qualification needed to move on to higher education. The problem is that too many students are struggling alone and could really benefit from connecting with hardworking teachers and other bright students in other parts of the country and the region. Join me, Dennis Brooks, this and every Friday evening from 8 to 9, with a repeat on Saturday morning from 8 to 9. For The A-Team, a study group on radio, my team of teachers, students, and experts will break down the syllabus, giving you information, tips, and past paper questions that will help you get top grades in your upcoming exams. Follow us on Facebook Live and on Twitter and be a part of the community. It's The A-Team. Fridays at 8 p.m. with a repeat at 8 o'clock on Saturday morning. It's your free extra class on radio and social media. And it's right here on Nationwide 90 FM, the revolution in media.
Yo, you hear me? I said, man, I did sit up saying, listening to the sauna, 1 to 3, every day on Nationwide. You know the job. Yeah.
Okay. Are we ready? So now you know we're in, right? We are now in the design studio, and today is Thursday. And you know what happens on Thursday, right? We give it things, but you have to earn it. Yes, so you're now in the design quiz. Yes? And we have a caller on the line. Hello, caller. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Hi, Karen. Good afternoon. This is Keisha. I'm calling from the city of Kingston.
You're calling from the big city of Kingston. Well, thank you very much for calling in. And I really do hope and pray that you have been a good steward and you have been listening every week. And, you know, and you're going to win today. You ready? Are you ready?
Okay.
All right, cool. All right. So, question number one. It is multiple choice. You have to get all five correct in order to win this can of paint, compliments of PH Paints. All right. What color scheme is typically recommended for small spaces? Dark and bold colors, bright and neutral colors, pastel and muted colors.
And that's B.
No, my darling. So sorry.
Okay.
The answer would be D, pastel and muted colors. Because remember, the lighter colors, the better it is. Okay, but I'm going to give you a little chance. You understand? If you get the other one correct, then you can go through. All right. Which furniture type is best suited for small spaces? Which furniture type is best suited for small spaces? Ready? Okay, large sectional sofa, oversized coffee table, or folding or multifunctional furniture?
See.
Very good. Yes, ding, 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 ding. Okay, so you're gone through now, you know. You have to get the rest of them right. All right. Which type of lighting is ideal for small spaces? We're talking about lighting now. Dim and moody lighting, overhead fluorescent lighting, floor lamps. Keisha, you sure about that?
Can you hear me?
You imagine I am here rooting for you, and you're going to tell me eh? Dim, remember, it's lighting, you know, for small spaces. Dim and moody lighting, overhead fluorescent lighting, or
hello,
D.
Hello, did you say dim or dim? I didn't get confused.
Oh,
right.
Dim, D, 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 dim,
yeah.
Dim,
yeah.
And moody lighting, overhead fluorescent lighting, or floor lamps.
And I say, hey.
Keisha, I tried to help you. I don't know what to do. Stay on the line. You can get some credit. Do we have anybody else? No? Okay. All right, YouTube, I'm going to throw it out to you. All right. So who's going to get this? Who's going to answer this? All right, here we go. Question that was not answered correctly. What type of lighting is ideal for small spaces? A, dim and moody lighting. B, overhead fluorescent lighting. Or D, floor lamps. YouTube, what say you? What say you, YouTube? What's coming up on yours, Jerome? Because my system here is very delayed and I can't see when them come up.
I see B.
B?
SH. No, not SH. Paul Pearl, say.
Said B, right? SH
B.
Said B?
Yeah.
Okay, SH, you're the winner on this one. All right, cool. What is a key principle of small space decor? As you can see in the questions, we're talking about small spaces today, right? And the quizzes on small spaces, because every week we come here with small spaces, so we have to have a quiz, don't it? Mm-hmm. All right, cool. So what is the key principle of a small space decor? Minimalism, maximalism, or cluttered spaces? What is the key principle of a small space decor? Minimalism, B, maximalism, or cluttered aesthetics? A would be minimalism. But, okay, no, they haven't answered yet.
SH what? Said minimalism.
Minimalism. Yeah, oh, SH, SH gone to the front of the class. Yes, there we go. A. Roslyn says B. No, baby, it's not B. Maximalism is when you have a huge home and you have big things, right? Okay. What should be considered when choosing small space storage solutions? Okay, hold on a minute. We do have a next caller. Hello, caller.
Hi, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, good afternoon. And what's your name and where you're calling from?
Judith, Spanish Town.
Hey, Judith. Big up to Spanish Town. All right, you know the rules, right? We're gonna be questioning. You're allowed to get one wrong. So you're good with that, right? And then after that, you get a chance to win a gallon of paint. All right, cool. So what should be considered when choosing small space storage solutions? A, size and scale. B, ornamentation and embellishments. Or C, randomness and mismatching.
Corinne, could you repeat A, please? I didn't hear it clearly.
Sure. Size and scale.
A.
Very good. Ding, 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 ding. You're gone through. Yes. All right. Jerome, I hope you're keeping score now.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Which of the following can visually expand a small space? A, heavy drapery. B, large area rugs. Or C, mirrors.
Mirrors.
Very good. Oh my God, she get 2 out of 2. Here we go. All right, ready again. Iron sharpens iron. Let's go. How can you create the illusion of higher ceilings in a small room? Painting the ceiling a dark color. Hanging low hanging light fixtures. Or C, vertical stripes on the walls.
Could you repeat, C, Karen? That was that.
Okay. How can you create the illusion of higher ceilings? Higher ceilings we're looking for, right? Painting the ceiling a dark color, hanging low hanging light fixtures, or vertical stripes on the walls?
Vertical stripes.
There you go.
On the wall?
Girl, you're gone again. That's 3 out of 3. Here we go now. All right. Which furniture arrangement is recommended for maximizing space in a small living room? A, placing furniture against the walls. B, creating a central conversation area. Or C, scattering furniture randomly.
Could you repeat the options again, please?
Sure. Which furniture arrangement is recommended for maximizing space in a small living room? A, placing furniture against the walls. B, creating a central conversation area. Or C, scattering furniture randomly.
B.
She gone clear. 4 out of 4. Okay, you have one more. Okay, what is a space-saving solution for a small kitchen? Installing a large kitchen island. Removing all cabinets. Using vertical storage options. So, A, installing a large kitchen island. B, removing all cabinets. Or C, using vertical storage solutions.
Could you repeat the question again for me, Karen? I heard the options, but I didn't hear the question.
Sure, no worries at all. What is a space-saving solution for a small kitchen?
Okay.
This is for the winner. Installing a large kitchen island, removing all cabinets, using vertical storage options.
Vertical solution.
Yes, ma'am. Ding, ding, ding. You have won yourself a gallon of paint courtesy of BH Paints. Congratulations. Stay on the line and speak with the lovely Rochelle. You're most welcome. You're most welcome. All right. So here's the thing now. YouTube, back to you. We have a little more time, so we're just going to end it with you. What is a good way to add personality to a small space? A, keeping everything neutral. B, incorporating unique accessories and artwork. Or C, avoiding any decorations. What is a good way to add personality to a small space? A, keeping everything neutral. B, incorporating unique accessories and artwork. Or C, avoiding any decorations. What you guys think? Anything coming yet, Jerome?
I see A.
A?
Yeah. Angela said A. SH said C.
Mm-hmm.
And she changed her answer. Said B. Angela has changed her answer.
She changed her answer?
Yeah, and said B.
Then it must be B. It must be B, you know. If you want to add personality to a small space, you have to put in some unique accessories. You know what I'm saying? Personality is how you put yourself into the space. All right, here we go now. Speed round now. Which type of flooring is recommended for small spaces? Flooring, meaning things you walk on, right? Here we go. Shaggy carpeting, dark hardwood floor, or light colored hardwood or laminate floor? Shaggy carpeting, dark hardwood floor, light colored hardwood or laminate floor? Which type of flooring is recommended for small spaces? Anything coming yet, Mr. Jerome?
It's refreshing.
Okay. Because my something over here said it's still an answer.
Yeah.
My own Lord have mercy, Jesus.
Oh, I said it said laminate floor.
Laminate, light colored hardwood or laminate floor? Yes, yeah. That is the answer. That is laminate the floor. Answer. Alrighty, so guys, thank you so very much for participating in the design quiz. So now, let me tell you something. Iron sharpens iron. Sharpen up those tools, because guess what? Tomorrow, next week, Thursday again, we are going to come back at you with the design quiz. And remember, just like CXC, the questions do come back. Alrighty, let's take a little break and come right back with you.
Get ready for a show like no other. That's right. Every Monday from 11 to 11:15 a.m., we're bringing you the Service Excellence Hub right here on Cliff Hughes Online. Join us as we dive into the heart of the government's commitment to service delivery in the public sector. The Public Sector Modernization Division within the Office of the Cabinet is dedicated to making your Mondays and Wednesdays informative. Get a front row seat to engaging interviews with public officials, updates to the latest service improvements as the government raises the bar on service standards. The Service Excellence Hub, because we believe in better services, better workforce, and better institutions. Brought to you by the Public Sector Modernization Division in the Office of the Cabinet. It's all about service with excellence.
Come join us outside with Pepita every Saturday from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. right here on Nationwide 90 FM. We bring you the views, the news, and we'll be cruising all around Jamaica.
Hey, surprise them with a bang.
For the hot spots, raindrop sunshine, we'll be there. Don't diss it, don't miss it. Outside with Pepita.
I'm Dennis Brooks.
I'm Alan Campbell.
I'm Floyd Green.
And I'm Garth Williams. Catch us on the Jamaican Dads Podcast right here on Nationwide 90 FM, Thursdays at 8 p.m. with a repeat on Sundays at 6 p.m.
The Jamaican Dads Podcast is all about providing men with a healthy, safe, and functional forum to tackle many of the taboo topics that concern our masculinity.
Like everyone else out there, we're dads of varying amounts of experience who come from different backgrounds and often view the world differently.
We're definitely not perfect, but we are all brethren and we're all committed to this piece of rock called Jamaica.
Too often, there are no safe spaces for men to explore the issues which are important to us.
Plus, most of the content out there about parenthood is produced by women, for women. So we think it is important that we be the change we want to see.
Follow us on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at Jamaican Dads with a Z.
And definitely join us here on Nationwide 90 FM every Thursday at 8 p.m. with a repeat on Sundays at 6 p.m. for the Jamaican Dads podcast. It's a revolution in media.
Get ready for a show like no other. That's right. Every Sunday from 8:15 p.m. to 9:15 p.m., we're bringing you The Harvest Hour, only on Nationwide 90 FM. Join us as we dive into a soothing religious program created for your mind, body, and soul. The World Harvest Mission Church, creators of The Harvest Hour, is dedicated to making your Sundays God-fearing and saintly. Get a front row seat to moving sermons and affectionate worshiping. That's The Harvest Hour, every Sunday from 8:15 p.m. to 9:15 p.m. Only on Nationwide 90 FM, the new revolution in media.
So now, Monday to Friday, on Nationwide 90 FM. This is Beanie Man. Give it to them. Zaga, them.
So good afternoon again, people. This is Karen Design Diva Booker, and welcome to the show. You are now in the second half of the Sound Off with myself, Triple X, and of course, DJ Jerome. So now we have on the phone Mr. Glenn Vernon of Weather Shield Limited. Mr. Vernon, are you there, sir?
Yes, I am here.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to the show.
Thank you, thank you.
And I hope it's not so hot outside for you. I hope you're in the shade and under the cool.
Sure, in the shade and under the cool.
Yeah, because you're a weather shield, so you're going to tell us some things about the weather. So please, please, let's pull back the curtain on Weather Shield Limited. Tell me about your business, please, sir.
Weather Shield Limited is a company primarily focused on roofing, waterproofing, gutters, and our EPS foam moldings that we use for decorating and leaving your house that kind of look you wanted to as a first entry to the outside looking in. That gives you the impression that someone has some taste when they're building their houses.
Of course. So you're talking about the foam that is the hottest thing right now since sliced bread, the EPS polystyrene foam. That is what you use to make all these moldings and so the inside the house that look like crown moldings, base moldings and stuff. That's what you're talking about, right?
That's what I'm talking about.
I am telling you, it is. Yeah. Can you just tell us how durable these are? Because we have the naysayers out there and I said, boy, if it make out the foam, then it can't. But please, go into it for me, please.
No, EPS foam is on the plastic family.
Yes.
So plastic, as you know, has a very long lifetime. It is waterproof, vermin-proof. It will not rot, deteriorate. So it will last a long time. That is the bare polystyrene foam.
Yes.
And it is also recyclable. So not because it is not can't be destroyed by vermin, but it can be recycled to making your clothes hangers, your CD cases, and
yes.
such like.
Yes, 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 yes. So therefore, we are reducing our carbon footprint, and we are really responsible in our green, you know, in terms of recyclable materials. So
that
you
is so.
You mentioned you do guttering.
Right.
Let's explain to people what guttering is.
Okay, so we have a machine that makes a seamless gutter, meaning you can get from 1 foot to 400 feet in one long stretch. That's what we have. It is made from aluminium, meaning it will withstand the elements. Not only that, but we also have a leaf filter that keeps leaves out of your gutter. So we recommend people have this rainwater.
Yes.
So whenever we install gutters on any premises, we always say to the clients, you need to get some tanks, whether it's a plastic tank or you build an underground tank and collect the rainwater just to water your ground, because the chlorine in the water kills the grass.
Yes, and it's soft and, water with what you get from heaven. So could you just explain to people what the important, what a gutter is, first of all, you know, which is, I want you, you are the expert, I want you to explain what a gutter is and why it's important to have a gutter, especially when you have outlaid all this money to buy a home.
So, guttering is basically a catchment system that is fixed to the end of your roof, mm-hmm. at the eaves of your roof, that mm-hmm. collects rainwater when it falls from the sky that mm-hmm. God blesses us with. Mm-hmm. So, when this catchment, this gutter collects the water, it prevents it from going around the perimeter of your house that destroys your foundation, that messes up the paint on the walls,
and
falls on the ground, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. And your plants, some, most of you, when you look around your house, there's a line around your house where the water falls on the ground. Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. that's what it does. It really, although it helps your plant, but it really does can create quite a mess if you don't have gutters, because you've just painted your house. They've just built your home.
Yes.
The lawn is not yet quite done. Mm-hmm. And rain falls. And all that mud and dust splashes onto your wall.
Right.
Not only that, mm-hmm. but when the rain falls and it blows onto your walls, you end up with moss and mold on your wall.
Yes,
and
yes.
if the paint is not good, it washes the paint off. And so your house immediately starts losing value.
So it is necessary.
So the gutter does a really wonderful job in protecting your property.
Yes, yes, it is necessary. In my opinion, it is necessary.
So
you are in roofing as well and construction supplies. Tell us a little bit about that.
So the roofing we provide is basically the roof covering, and we do the installation of the roof members as well.
Okay.
So we install the asphalt shingles, the clay tiles, the custom length sheets, and the other metal tiles that is on the market, stone coated or the plain mold, plain tiles that you have, Decabond, Decatile, and such the like. And that is what is. And if you want us to do cedar shingles for you, which is we're going out, we can do cedar shingles for you as well.
Okay. All right. So I know you sound somebody who's very, you know, up on your business, as so you should. Do you have any significant technological advancements going in your business? Because I know if it is that you are fully green and you're recyclable and you use all these tools, there must be some kind of advancements that you're using that makes you competitive.
But I tell you, especially in our supplies for the moldings, we are just about the only other company that does that kind of business in Jamaica,
uh-huh.
right? That is the moldings. And as far as the guttering is concerned, mm-hmm. we have very few individuals that does the kind of guttering that we do. Most companies will put up a gutter with an external bracket.
Yes.
We have an internal bracketing system. So when you look up on the gutters, you don't see any bracket. It's hidden on the inside.
Mm-hmm.
So the gutters look like a molding dressed around your roof.
Mm-hmm.
That was quite pleasing.
Mm-hmm.
And because of that internal bracketing system, we can put in your gutter, as I said before, a leaf filter that keeps leaves out. With the external brackets, there is no way to put a filter in. So all the muck and grime and dust and dirt that's mm-hmm. on your roof
mm-hmm.
goes into your gutter. And if you have a tank, you're
mm-hmm.
collecting all of that in your tank.
Exactly. Yeah, which is not good. So I'm loving the fact that you are so competitive in terms of the landscape of so on, because if you are the only company who is offering, or one of the only companies that is offering, that means that you have really looked at the needs in Jamaica and you have said, you know what, this is necessary. Because and we're just going to talk about the guttering for a minute. One,
sure.
if you have a tank on your roof and for some reason, you know, the water is collecting up there, you know, we're talking about mosquitoes, we're talking about, you know, all level mold and moss and everything up there. If the water, because water is so organic, if it needs somewhere to go, so
right.
what you are doing now is channeling it. And what you're saying to what I heard from you, say, listen, even if you get a barrel, you know, everybody get barrel from foreign, the plastic ones, harvest
yes,
the water
yes.
there,
harvest the water.
I want your plants.
I think last year was worse than terms of rainfall, and the government is saying you need to harvest the water.
You do.
And this is the opportunity that is there now, and the government needs to take the steps to ensure that all new constructions, especially the National Housing Trust, we can't have a national agency building houses and do not have in place a water collecting system from the premises. Because when you give them a black tank, all they do is empty Hermitage or Mona and put in the tank. You want
yes.
them to collect rainwater,
yes.
treat it with filter, filters that yes. we also sell, so you can get a filtration system from one level to seven levels, including a UV treatment that kills bacteria.
Wow.
So that is what is needed. And maybe government can look at giving credits to installing these systems to encourage people to put up these rainwater harvesting systems.
Exactly,
it's important, critical in this stage of development that we have these things in place.
Because, as you know, preventative methods are better than curing the aftermath. You understand?
So you're out of water and the Hermitage is going down all the time. Mona is going down all the time.
All the time.
And yet you are not putting incentives in place for individuals to collect rainwater. That really, to me, is kind of a challenging situation to look at.
Well, I'm going to thank you for at least, just touching on that subject and broadening that conversation that, hey, listen, not only can you have the gutters in your home, we really should look at the entities that be to offer incentives so that everybody's yes. home can have the guttering. And I'm sure that this conversation started here can definitely, carry on to the ears because everybody listens to this show. And we will continue this conversation further. No, Mr. Glenn Vernon, right. Where can we reach you? What are your social handles? Because we need to get in touch with you about these things.
Well, once you go Gutters Jamaica, we will come up on Google.
Huh?
You can also Google Maps. You search us and it'll pop up right in front of you.
Oh.
Our numbers are 876-940-4111. That's 876-940-4111. And 956-5286. So once you go online, Google and search for Gutters in Jamaica, anywhere,
mm-hmm.
Weatherfield will come up,
mm-hmm.
and you can see us and track us and find us and drive to us
and
Google
drive
Maps.
To. Where are you exactly?
We are in Montego Bay.
Oh, you're in Montego Bay.
Right.
Okay.
But we work all Jamaica is a small place.
Yes,
so
it is.
You can find us and we can access you anywhere you are.
And we have road now, so we can reach you.
Ah.
Thank you so very much, Mr. Vernon, and we will speak very, very soon.
Thank you too.
All right, guys, we're up on a little break, and we're going to come right back and talk up some things because it is Relationship Thursday, don't it?
Live exquisite this year with new arrival black and chrome fixtures for your home at Unique Living. Select from a wide variety of rain shower systems, fabulous faucets, and stylish sinks to suit your kitchen and bathrooms. Get uncompromised quality and style unique to you. Shop everything new at Unique Living, Jamaica's leading shower and faucets provider. Visit shop number 6, 30 Dunrobin Avenue, Kingston 10, or call 876-755-3661-2.
Do you have a consumer-related issue? Want to learn more about matters concerning you as a consumer? Well, keep it locked to Nationwide 90 FM for the Consumer Hour with me, Nora Gay Banton, weekdays from 9 to 10 a.m. For all your consumer-centric matters, stay tuned to the Consumer Hour on Nationwide 90 FM, a revolution in media.
You deserve a beautiful home. Join the expert Karen Booker, your design diva, this and every Saturday at 1 to 2 p.m. here on Nationwide 90 FM. Learn what's really behind the design. Access insights and hacks that'll have your home looking like it was snatched from a magazine cover. From cushions to curtains, choosing colors to carpets, Karen will teach you the secret of the pros. That's the Design Studio every Saturday at 1 p.m. here on Nationwide 90.
History for tomorrow. Yesterday's narrative, today's guide. Join us as we discuss the people, places, and events that have influenced the world as it is today. Remember, knowing your history is essential to understanding the present. So join us on History for Tomorrow, Saturdays at 9 to 11 a.m. with repeats Mondays at 9:30 p.m.
Some of the smartest dummies carry the language of Egyptian mummies on a flag of a moon. Can't find food for the starving tummies. Pay no mind to the youths.
And so now, Monday to Friday, on Nationwide, 90 FM. This is Beanie Man. Give it to them, Zaga, Zen.
Pimpin, you're thinking what me thinking. But me have a fuss, you feel like you're there. I would have one pana. Hey, girl, are you me one? Fulfill my dream. Come wind up on me. Now I'm in the slow motion. Deep for your heart, wine in the ocean. The style where you give me smooth, no lotion. It make the wave them arise up in a me ocean. You know, brace from far, go give me the close one. Another that alone, I make the loving so strong. Me want buy a ring where value 30,000. Cause you fee be me wife, me fee be your husband. Baby, me love the way you wine. You put a smile for me face, yeah, girl. Stick on for me body, embrace, yeah, girl. Me love when you wine up your waist, yeah, girl. Baby,
me love. My guilty pleasure, Vibes. You know I'm not a Vibes fan, but that song nice. All right, YouTube, I have a gift for you. For the winners this afternoon, please call the station. Please call the lovely Miss Rochelle Pinnock at 876-630-937-124 for your credit. If it is that you do not live in Jamaica, then please send a designated somebody to pick up your credit. Okay? Alrighty. Alright, so here's the thing now. It's Relationship Thursday. Okay? And, you know, sometimes we might be living with a significant other, friend. Okay, all right. But before I go into this talk up segment now, Jerome, who is the person who won on who's the person who won on YouTube?
I think it's SH.
SH. SH. Yeah, you are the winner on YouTube. Would you please call the station? Rochelle is expecting a call. 876-630-937-124. All right. And you could, she can WhatsApp too, just in case. Yeah, you can WhatsApp as well. 876-280-6629. Because I know it's easier to WhatsApp from foreign. If you are in foreign. All right. So here's the thing now. You know, sometimes we're in these relationships, we're in these marriages, and, you know, our significant other wants to go somewhere without us. How do you handle that? How do you handle that, Jerome? Razi, how do you handle that? Your significant other won't go out without you. And not only does he want to go out without you, or she wants to go out without you, she is going out, or he's going out to a party of the opposite gender. So let me just ask the question to the YouTubers and everybody out there who's riding along, especially the people who are riding along. I'd love for you to call me. Baby, good afternoon. One of my friends have a birthday party, you know, and she invite me to go to it, and I'm seeking your permission to go.
Permission?
Yes. One of my friends is having a party, and she has invited me to go, and I am seeking your permission to go. Oh. What say you if the shoe was on the other foot? So Razi say I'm not insecure. Can go on. Go on to your party. I don't know.
Yeah, trust have a big role to play, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Because insecurity come with trust. If you don't trust the person, you're gonna insecure about their whereabouts.
And no matter what you do.
No matter what you do. Once you don't trust a person, you're going to be insecure.
Yeah.
And that's
exactly
just
and trust has to be earned.
Exactly.
You don't just get up one day and say, oh, I trust you, or I don't trust you. You know what I'm saying? So really, trust has to be earned. And if you have a track record of going to places and breaching someone's trust, because let me tell you something, you see, once that trust is breached, it is nearby impossible to get
near
it back, don't it?
Near.
It
can.
It can, but you have to work. You have to work, Fitina.
But I think you build trust based off actions and not words.
There you go.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
Yeah. Hmm. Yeah. 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 So you see, actions, that means that you have to be consistent. Mm-hmm. You have to be truthful. You have to be transparent. Are you willing to do that work to bring back the trust in your relationship?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? My view, make them go on. You never have to ask me permission.
I mean, you don't have to ask. But tell me, sir. Yo, you know what I'm saying, Ray? I'm here to do something. Zara, do your thing.
Do your thing.
Yeah.
Do your thing. Why are you coming to me like, oh, you're the very fact that this person would say, I am seeking your permission. You can see that there is some trust things going on right here. You understand? And this person going to do what them want to do anyway. But you know what he's going to say at the end of it? Well, you said me could have did go.
Yeah, I may ask permission.
So you can't come back to me now and say, imagine this, that, and the third. You know, News says he can ask if she's comfortable with him going without her, if she had plans for them, but not permission. So what News is saying that, yeah, the way he posed the question, like, are you comfortable with me going without me?
But the truth, in fact, Anna, everywhere we are going, we woman follow, we go still.
No, but the thing about it is, Jerome, he is is another gender. Remember, you know, it's the opposite gender. If it's not going, it's not a night where I'm just going to hang out with the boys. Friends. It's another lady. You know, it could be a touchy subject.
What is
especially
there a history behind?
That's what the way this question is posed.
Yeah, I think
it looks like
there
is something behind this. Why he would say, I am seeking your permission. Like, may I seek employment?
Is it that she want him already about this person? Yeah. Or she have thoughts about this person?
Something or something, because there is some history there. You know. I don't think she probably knows who this particular female is, but he says one of my friends has a birthday party and she invited me to go. Right? So therefore she must know that this is a man that have Wolipa Jing Bang. Hang on. It's a him. Right. Yeah. Rochelle is saying, why is he asking in the first place? There's trust issues there.
Yeah.
This is huge trust issues. Mm-hmm. And for the ladies who are saying, I don't want my man go anywhere without me, you better go have a seat somewhere, because he's going to go regardless.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? You have to give people room to do what it is that they want to do. You give them room. If you do not give them room in order to socialize without you, you're setting up yourself for big, big, big problems.
Yeah, you will hear, I need some space.
I can't hear you, Rochelle. Yeah, okay, Rochelle is saying, But yeah, we covered it. Mm-hmm. Rochelle is saying, the next question is it okay for your partner to be going out with the opposite sex? But it's not that he is going out with the opposite gender, you know. She is having a party and she invite him. It's not like him saying, I am going out to Burger King with this lady. He's saying, she having a birthday party. Party, not birthday, you know, going out or whatever, party. She invite me. Some women would say that, how come she know you in a relationship and she don't invite both of us?
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? Some women would say that is disrespectful. Some people will say, well, wait, me don't know you. Like the woman would say, I don't know your lady. But some people would say, regardless of the fact of who you know that you are with somebody. So therefore, the invitation should have been extended to both of you. Now, hear the other part of the story now, Jerome. If they're going to say, then okay, if she going to invite you and you don't invite me, right? Then that mean you going around telling the people, say, you don't have somebody. Oh my goodness gracious, and the conversation continues and continues. So Majestic said, but if the person respects you, they can let you know going out depends on the length, also let you know they're going out, and it also depends on the length of the relationship, right? Tifa Tash said, yep, they can include unicorns in the relationship. It's their thing, clearly. What is this? All right, Leroy says, but I don't think any woman trusts me. Keep asking myself why though. Open relationship, maybe? No, if it was an open relationship in a Tifa Tash, he would have just gone. He would have just said, he wouldn't ask permission. If it's an open relationship, he would say, you know what, it's Friday night, I'm not here.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? And please, people, be very careful with open relationships, because you think that you may not catch feelings, but sometimes you do catch feelings and you get hurt. You know, so I'm thinking when it comes to relationship things and whatever, just keep it clean, keep it respectful, keep it transparent, keep the trust intact, And you cannot, you must not ever back yourself into a corner where your boyfriend or your husband or so feels that him can't go anywhere without you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Trust has to be in a relationship some kind of way. Don't it, Jerome?
It cannot be too clingy.
Yeah. Yeah, and attached. Just know.
You have to be willing to give the person some space.
Some space and some room.
Yeah.
Yeah? It's just always, you know, when you and somebody just start going out and whatever, and all about you and it's all about, and everywhere you go, you see the other one and all of it. That gets old real fast.
Very fast.
You understand? So if it is, you need to set your boundaries and your things first of all and say, listen, on Friday night, I'm with my girls. On Tuesday night, I do ballet. And on Saturday mornings, I go to the gym. You understand what I'm saying? Is when you get caught up in a relationship first and you start to relax those rules, that is when people feel that them can't go nowhere without you.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? And then that is when it poses a problem, mm-hmm. and then it becomes an issue. So people, thank you so very much for entertaining everybody. You entertained me, I entertained you, people called in. It was lovely. It was a great show. So thank you so much for joining and sharing space with me today. I have some people to thank. Of course, I have to thank the lovely producers, Miss Rochelle Pinnock and Miss Jereen Campbell. Of course, DJ Razzie. He is here every day and he even played my promo, guys. Yeah. Like me today, because you know, Design Studio is on Saturday, the extended version, and I heard my promo, which I haven't heard in a minute. But so, thank you, DJ Razzie, and of course, Jerome, who actively participated today in the Sound Off. So, thank you so very much.
You're most welcome.
Yes. So, everybody, it's over and out for me. I will see you tomorrow alongside Mr. Triple X. He will be back all in one piece. Love and light to you all, and have a great afternoon.
You give me good love, close to remind me. So I'm for this you.
When the sun gone down and the lover come down, woman get out and want to have fun. Remember you say me and your sugar plum plum. Remember you tell me you not give me bum.
Me be anything I anything. Me will do the things them as long as you want me. Me be anything I anything. Me will do the things them as long as you want me.
Say you love the general. Don't give up when you go over here.
Me not give you no time. All I get up in your eyes.
Remember when me tell Shiba. Tell her when me do, you make you do me that.
Love man, I lose me, I ruin me. I tell you the truth, but it not work.
When the sun gone down and the lover come down, woman get out and want to have fun.
So long, farewell to you, my friends. Goodbye for now. Until we meet again, I say so long, farewell to you, my friend. Goodbye for now, until we meet again. It's been great to play and sing together
in the box.
And now